ultimatum. Let's dive right in. However, here it's aggressive, it's right in your face. We've saturated and distorted the sound. The inspiration for this hurdy-gurdy riff came from us playing around with the synths. We came up with this really cool bending synth riff. However, since it's Geralt's action scene, we needed a hurdy-gurdy. Here, hurdy-gurdy takes the lead with the melody line. We wanted the double bass to sound really greedy, dirty, violent. Therefore, its sound is very aggressive and heavily processed. Check out how cool it is. In order to match the action and the camera movement, we reversed a lot of our percussive elements. This fight sequence is incredibly badass. It's cool, it's unique, and so it required a really unique and contemporary music approach. We were looking for a driving element in the high register that wasn't too intrusive. Dulcimer was the perfect choice. As we discussed before, rhythmical breathing is a very important element for the Witcher action sequences. So here it kicks in. The climax of the scene is coming up. Geralt and Renfri will now face each other in a dramatic fight sequence. Here was the perfect moment to reprise Renfri's scene in a dramatic and violent way. We love making these snare hits so reverby and epic, giving them an 80s vibe. It was incredibly important for us to sing the music with every Geralt sword hit, every cut, so watch this scene really closely. Now that the action part is finally over, the atmosphere becomes much darker, more somber, more emotional. The shruti box comes in, followed by a harmonium. Both harmonium and shruti box are used extensively throughout the whole season. Fun fact, we borrowed this shruti box from Declan De Barra, writer and supervising producer on the series. The vocals come back again with Renfri's theme. The vocals are deeply emotional. These are Renfri's last moments. Renfri tells Geralt about the girl in the woods, which we know is Ciri. Therefore, Renfri's theme is now doubled by a hoon, which is Ciri's instrument. On Kahir's horse to make this scene even more frantic in order to reflect what's on screen. We invited our violinist Lindsay Deutsch to help with the growth. This moment is really particular, the hurdy-gurdy melody on top plays seriously. At the same time, the low bass and the brass perform Nilfgaard scene. Furthermore, we keep switching between 4-4 and 7-8, with 7-8 being the rhythm of Nilfgaard we use throughout the whole season. The 7-8 riff was absolutely perfect for Nilfgaard. The last 8th note being cut out gave this rhythm an unstoppable feeling. This sequence is a perfect example of two completely different themes, two different forces clashing together. I hope you enjoyed this quick dive into this track, and hey, stay tuned for more!